Wow. There's a hole, I believe, so all the track and field angels can look down and see what's going on.
Mm-hmm. Well, they will be looking down on history. Elaine Thompson-Hira with that Olympic record. Not here, but these eight women are poised and ready to go. Three Americans, one Jamaican, one St. Lucian, one athlete from the Ivory Coast, and two Europeans from Great Britain and Switzerland, all with aspirations of a place in the history books. The rain still coming down, but it all adds to the occasion and the sense of anticipation. And how great, Carrie Tollefson, the women's 100-meter final comes first.
It's been amazing. The entire time we've been here at the Olympics, we've been talking about what they're doing for female athletes. And it is about time to see some of the best here in the 100 meters. One of the greatest things, and I don't know if a lot of people understand, but they're going to end the Olympic Games with the women's marathon. The first time they're ever doing that. That's pretty awesome.
Well, you notice there's nobody out there now, so that means we're getting ready for the show, Rob.
Woo!
Okay, what's your instinct, John Anderson? You spend a lot of time in the United States. Do you think this is the world champion's night to shine?
I did until I saw Julien Alfred in the semis, and
I thought she was so impressive.
If we can't pick the same one, then maybe I go. I'll go chalk then. Give me the favorite horse in the race.
Well, I mean, you can't go wrong with Sha'Carri Richardson. She's amazing.
Tanisha Terry, TT Terry. To her friends, she'll be in lane 9. Relay golds for the United States. But this is for individual glory. She'll need to be quicker than she was in the semis. Melissa Jefferson, the fourth fastest woman in the world this year, put her career on hold to give a bone marrow transplant to her father at the age of 17. She's bounced back with the family watching. What an extraordinary moment it would be for her to deliver glory for the United States. No Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, no Sharika Jackson, no Elaine Thompson-Hira, but Jamaica represented with Tia Clayton. Brilliant in qualification, 10.89. How will she cope with the pressure, with the conditions, with the eyes of the world watching? Daryl Nita made the final 3 years ago in Tokyo. Looks composed, looks ready. Was disappointed with European silver in Rome a couple of months ago, which shows you the scale of her aspirations and self-belief. Nita will be in lane 8. For Switzerland, Majinga Kambunji, she beat Daryl Nita by a whisker to that European title in Rome. She also won the world indoor crown over 60 meters. She's got a great start when she's on her game. Could she explode out of the blocks and into the Swiss history books? They're in the stadium and their flags are ready. One of the most important figures in African sport in the last couple of decades, Marie-Jose Talu-Smith. So often it's been fourth place in the Olympic Games. She's dreading a repeat outcome, and she would roar with delight if she gets on the podium. Looked really good in qualification. Julien Alfred, the fastest qualifier, the third quickest woman in the world this year, the world indoor champion. Could she secure St. Lucia's first Olympic medal? A proud Caribbean island nation will be holding their breath thousands of miles away. And now to the queen of sprinting, the headline maker. Is she a record breaker? World champion. Fastest woman in the world this year. Bidding to become the first American female Olympic champion over 100 meters for almost 3 decades. What an occasion for everybody to savor. Kambunji. Talu-Smith, Clayton, Jefferson, Alfred, Richardson, Nita Terry.
Here's the range lightened a little bit here.
Their faces are a picture of concentration. More than two decades ago, these incredible women were just eight little girls daring to dream that a night like this might one day belong to them. And after a lifetime of work and sacrifice, at last it's their turn. So here they stand, in the pouring rain, the best in their country, the best on their continent, bidding to become the best in the world. An iconic moment of sport is about to unfold in all its glory. This is the women's 100-meter Olympic final. Alfred got a brilliant start in the semi-final, and she's away well again. She's up on Richardson at the moment. Julien Alfred, the history maker, the gold medalist in the pouring rain. It's all sunshine for the St. Lucian star. They've never won a medal before, and now they've taken the best one of the lot. Julien Alfred has stunned Richardson, the favourite, the world champion, was left in her blocks, and the St. Lucian has just etched her name into history forever. Gold for Julien Alfred, with a phenomenal time as well. That was phenomenal. Richardson the silver, Jefferson the bronze, but everybody will be talking about Julien Alfred and the way she has seized history and denied the American favorite the gold her nation have craved for almost three decades.
She held the weight of her country on her shoulder. Listen to that! Yes! She's done so many things to prepare herself. She's moved away from home at the age of 14. She moved to the States. She has left a lot behind to do this so she could bring more back home. She says her coach has been more like a dad, a mentor, and obviously someone that has gotten her through so many things.
Yeah,
congratulations.
Well, I have to follow her as she'll go over, because we saw Edric Floreal. He's over there in the triple jump area watching.
Yeah.
Akelia Smith, Melissa Jefferson with a fabulous run into third. So it's not a Jamaican, but the Caribbean nations again produced the fastest women in the world.
Well, it was just blistering, wasn't it? It was blistering.
Look at that.
And it was never in doubt. From 10 meters out, she was out, and it was...
It was her race.
And it was over.
Yep. You know, you didn't see a lot of smiling in the last couple hours by this woman. She was all game face, and now it's all smiles. But look at the smile on that woman's face as well, and she deserves that. She is someone that has put the weight of the shoulders on her as well. Sha'Carri Richardson, you are awesome, and we are so excited to watch you.
The thing I hope for all the hype that surrounded her, and she led in the States every Olympic coverage, every promo was Sha'Carri Richardson and Noah Lyles. A silver medal is an unbelievable accomplishment, and to come where she was 3 years ago in Tokyo to a world championship and then to do that, I could have guaranteed you those tears were coming.
Yeah, and then Melissa Brown, such a great... Melissa Jefferson, just such a great story as well. But look at the emotion.
And I told you, she went home this summer. It had been the first time she had been home in quite some time. Her mom had come to the States. I met her when she was in Denver for the Bowerman Award, which is the best, given to the best collegiate track athlete. And she won going away and gave this magnificent speech. And then she went home this year and saw how many people are invested in her. And it kind of, to use her coach, kind of freaked her out.
Sure.
I can't believe this. And he spent so much time, he took her off the track because she had some horrible races. He said, you can't run with all these people on your shoulder. Yes, they're invested in you, but that's because they want you to win. They're pushing you right here in this moment. They are behind you, they are lifting you up, and they are pushing you to this result.
Look at how strong she is right here. Just powering her way through, but look at Sha'Carri Richardson closing in hard, but Julien Alfred just had too much, way too much tonight.
Richardson got left in the blocks as she did in the semi-finals, and she could not find an answer. She did in Budapest, but not tonight. Images that will be replayed in St. Lucia again and again and again. No medal. And now the women's Olympic champion over 100 metres. And it is a beautiful, proud island. I've had the privilege of going there a couple of times. They love their cricket, but I tell you what, they're going to love their athletics now.
Can you imagine Jefferson being 23 years old? She's looking in the crowd, looking for family and friends and coaches and just wondering who's out there. But wow, what an awesome race for her to be in and to snag that bronze medal.
Otto Bolton, the great commentator for NBC and who is very familiar from Trinidad and Tobago with the Caribbean Islanders and the sprinters there, he had said, you know, everybody always knew about Julien Alfred, but they didn't see this as the top end, that she was there and she would have to be kind of contended with, but that she would become the one to beat maybe wasn't what they saw. And she said when she went to the University of Texas, she was just this little girl, far from home, kind of lost. And as she's grown as a sprinter and grown as a person and into this championship young woman.
That was all her tonight. She had a lot of space.
It's an island nation. She's used to the water.
Wow. What a way to do it against Richardson, who is on her way to being regarded as one of the greats, the fastest woman in the world this year, the reigning world champion.
And it's a long time since she's had to give chase. And credit to her, held her form. That could have easily gotten away from her. You lose your form, like you panic a little bit. And suddenly, in an event where it is obviously tens and hundreds, you know, it's easy to fall back to fifth or sixth. And she kept it together to get the silver medal.
Julien Alfred is the Olympic champion. Silver this time for the world champion, Richardson, and Jefferson. A brilliant, brave, fantastic bronze.